1 minute, 30 seconds. Mark.
So again, we're just a little under a minute and a half away from launch. It's only about a 9 minute ride into orbit, so the next 10 minutes get a lot more exciting for us here as Antares is about to lift off from the Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia.
Copy, core one. T-minus 1 minute. Mark.
Preliminary fuel tank pressurization started.
Roger that, core one.
Wallops on best source telemetry.
T-minus 30 seconds. Mark. T-minus 10. Mark. Five, four, three, two, one.
Antares lifting off, going across the night sky, disappearing through some clouds quickly and coming quickly back into view. The first stage looking nominal or normal so far, lighting up the night sky there above Virginia. Orbital ATK's Antares on its way. Getting good performance calls, the attitude, the orientation of the rocket looking normal. Just passing through max Q, the maximum aerodynamic pressure. That's where the forces of launch, the highest on the launch vehicle. First stage, though, continuing to fire. It's going to cut off about 215 seconds into the flight, or just a little over 3 minutes.
Pressures remain nominal. TBC looks good. Vehicle attitude is nominal. Passing 100,000 feet altitude and 7,000 feet per second. Engines remain at full thrust. Attitude still good. Avionics power is good. TVC steering looks good. Passing 150,000 feet. Engine steady as 100% thrust as we pass 10,000 feet.
And getting a great animation now as we get the performance calls still from the Orbital ATK flight engineers. Everything looking good so far with Antares. As you can see, already in an altitude of over 37 miles, 38 miles and climbing. The vehicle approaching 6,000 miles an hour in velocity already.
The slow throttle ramp.
You can see its flight path in the lower right corner. Again, it flies in the southeasterly trajectory away from Virginia, out over the Atlantic Ocean.
Nominal operation at 55%. It's passing 15,000 feet per second. TVC slewing for main engine shutdown.
And we're going to be standing by for MECO, or main engine cutoff, for the first stage.
1,000 foot altitude. Core pressures remain nominal with VNO4 and VNO5 open. And we have MECO.
And MECO, or that main engine cutoff, is confirmed. The first stage, the fuel gone, its job done, dropping away.
Antares is in a brief coast phase now while we wait for the right conditions.
As Matt described, now we're in a bit of a coast stage here.
ACS is enabled.
Yeah, a short coast phase here, and next event will be the fairing separation.
We had nominal stage one burnout velocity at just over 17,300 feet per second. We have fairing separation and interstage separation.
All right, well, the fairing and the interstage dropping away. Cygnus in the second stage now exposed.
We have T plus 260, and we have stage two ignition.
And a good confirmation, the engine on stage two, it's a solid rocket motor, now ignited. And it's going to continue to boost Cygnus into orbit.
Stage two ramping up to full pressure. The Castor 30 motor will burn for approximately 150 seconds. Avionics power remains nominal. Stage two attitude is nominal. Stage two TVC performance looks good. Castor 30XL motor is passed.
Everything continuing to look great with this flight so far. The vehicle already traveling in excess of 10,000 miles an hour for 100 miles in altitude.
Power remains nominal.
As we're just a little over 5 minutes into the flight already.
Power systems remain good. Stage two TVC is nominal. Power is nominal. We're approximately halfway through stage two burn at this point. Avionics systems remain healthy at this point. Stage 2 TVC is nominal.
So just about 1 minute left on the second stage firing.
All systems are performing well at this point.
As you're hearing, everything's still looking good with Cygnus and the Antares rocket.
Power remains good. Attitude remains nominal. Castor 30XL motor pressure starting to tail off. Power systems remain good. Stage two, and we have stage two burnout. Antares will now coast for approximately 2 minutes before payload separation. FTS is disabled.
And with that second stage cut off and the coast now underway, the Antares rocket largely done its job so far. So it's going to continue to coast. We'll get these performance calls from the orbital engineers. But everything's still looking really good for Cygnus. Soon going to be in its preliminary orbit and then get ready to deploy the solar arrays following that, and then begin its chase down of the International Space Station.
Nominal avionics power systems all look good at this point. Power is nominal. Attitude remains nominal as we await payload separation. Power is still good. Attitude is nominal. Power is nominal. Attitude is good. Power is nominal.
And now we're standing by for that payload separation.
Power systems remain healthy. And we have Cygnus spacecraft separation.